The Biden's administration and open border advocates, their definition of humane is to open our borders, don't detain anyone, release them to the United States, and not deport them.
Joining me once again is Mark Morgan. He's the former acting commissioner of Customs and Border Protection, as well as a visiting fellow at the Heritage Foundation. Mark, thanks for joining me again.
Thanks for having me.
Now, to kick us off, I want to talk about a White House press briefing that happened relatively recently where Fox News's Peter Ducey actually asked the White House Press Secretary Jen Psaki about these migrant facilities that were just reopened. And I'm just going to play the clip for you so you can get an idea of the exact moment I'm talking about.
Kamala Harris said that this facility, putting people in this facility, was a human rights abuse committed by the United States government. And Joe Biden said, under Trump, there have been horrifying scenes of border at the border of kids being kept in cages. Now, it's not under Trump, it's under Biden.
This is not kids being kept in cages.
So first and foremost, it feels like the terminology has changed. It feels like the media coverage has changed. But what exactly at the border has changed?
Yeah, you look, I watched that press conference. I've been doing this, serving this country for over 35 years, served under six different administrations, both Republican and Democrat. I've never seen so much misinformation, misdirection, spin, blatant lies coming from the White House in my entire 35 years. And Mr. Ducey was one of the only reporters that asked a somewhat direct question. The rest were softballs. I stood exactly where she stood in that same spot. And I can tell you, those reporters never let me get away with something like that. They were coming at me with every difficult, hard question they could. And the responses that they gave, the misinformation, misdirection was never allowed. And that's all we heard that day at the White House. It's just remarkable that it's being allowed to go on.
Why do you think it's being allowed to go on?
Look, you know, again, I've been doing this for a long time. At the end of the day, the only thing that makes sense for me is that the mainstream media is really an arm of the Democratic Party. And look, what's very important is that these facilities, while I appreciate all the discussion about the hypocrisy, right, and it clearly is, and I think most people are starting to get that, is that these are the exact same facilities that were utilized under the Trump administration, and then they were immoral and unjust and inhumane. Now they're the exact same facilities being used under a Democrat administration, and all of a sudden it's different, it's essential, and they're humane. I think people get that. But here's what's important. It's how the facilities are being utilized. It's how the resources are being utilized. It's 180 degrees. Under Trump, those resources and facilities were used to prevent, apprehend, detain, and remove lawfully. Now those facilities are being utilized to release people as fast as humanly possible, knowing they will never show up for their court hearing, and then prevent ICE from lawfully deporting them. So that's the key part that a lot we're not talking about, that they're creating reception centers on the border and a sanctuary country on the back end, and they're doing it by design because they see a perceived political benefit by doing so.
Roberta Jacobson, who is President Biden's southern border coordinator, talking about this surge that we're seeing, you know, talking about that we've seen this surges before, and I just want to go back to 2014 and talk about that migrant crisis. By the numbers, how is what's going on right now different than what we saw, you know, for better or for worse?
It's not. And so you have to look at 2014, what kind of started this, right? DACA started this in the forced settlement agreement, who said we couldn't keep kids or families in our custody for more than 20 days. It's impossible to get through the immigration process in 20 days. Hence the beginning of catch and release. And by that time, it already started 2018, 2019. By 2019, we had closed that down through the Remain in Mexico policy, the asylum cooperative agreements with the Northern Triangle countries, and I could go on and on. And all of that has been dismantled. So when they dismantled all of that, this isn't anything new. We are in the middle of Einstein's definition of insanity, and we knew it, and we told them, and key players in the Biden administration knew it too, like the current DHS secretary. He was there as the deputy secretary of DHS when we saw another crisis, and he knew exactly what would happen.
Something that Jacobson also talked about was, you know, surges tending to respond to hope. And there was significant hope for a more humane policy after, you know, 4 years of President Trump. What are your thoughts on that? And is what we're seeing at the border right now a sign of hope?
Yeah, well, Exactly. It is. I mean, what she said people should listen to, hope. And that's exactly what this administration is doing. They have delivered hope to these migrants, as well as given a blank check, right, and a roadmap for the cartels to exploit it. And that's exactly what they're doing. But their hope, everybody needs to understand what the definition of hope is. And the hope that they're providing is, once again, if you make it to our border illegally, we're going to let you in, and then we're going to protect you from lawful deportation. You're going to be able to remain in the country illegally forever, and then eventually we're going to give you a pathway to citizenship. That's the hope. And let's be very clear. I get so frustrated we have to dismantle everything to make it humane. That's absolutely a lie. We need to understand the Biden's administration and open border advocates, their definition of humane is to open our borders, don't detain anyone, release them in the United States, and not deport them. That's what they mean by humane. So any policies that enforce our borders, our sovereign laws, it supports our sovereignty as a nation, that's inhumane. We have to be very careful to define what they mean by that.
This Reuters report that was released on Wednesday points out concerns from Mexican officials over the new president's immigration policies as apprehensions at the southern border hit a 15-year high in February. Is the Biden administration, straining the country's relationship with Mexico in a way that could ultimately backfire on us?
Absolutely. That's a great question. So that's another just misinformation. And quite frankly, I think a lie they're telling American people. And they're trying to insinuate that we didn't have good relationship with the government of Mexico and the Northern Triangle countries. That's just a flat out lie. We have the best relationships with Mexico and the Northern Triangle countries with respect to the illegal immigration flow than we've ever had. Unprecedented agreements that we are all working together, right, to address this as a regional crisis that it is. And we were together, we were addressing it. Now, if I'm the government of Mexico, if I'm the president, if I'm AMLO, I'm saying, what are you doing? Now, America, you have created, this is a self-inflicted wound, a self-inflicted crisis that you have created. And now, once again, the illegal migration flow is going through my country. Mexican citizens, they don't want it either. It's devastating for their country as well as it is for the United States. So if I'm the president of Mexico, at some point, I'm calling out Biden. I'm saying, what are you doing, Joe? You got to stop this. We had this locked down, and you have totally dismantled it. And now here we go again. February, 100,000 in a single month. We're getting to 5,000 a day, and they still refuse to call it a crisis, right? They don't want to put a label on it, but the president doesn't have a problem putting a label on the governor of Texas and calling him a Neanderthal for what he's doing on the COVID front.
I'd love to have you back on to talk about it as these developments continue and if there's any solutions in sight. So Mark Morgan, thank you so much for joining me.
You bet. Anytime. Have a good day.